Hello friends, do you like drawing? Nowadays there are so many styles in drawing and so many different types of colors are available. But do you know that the primitive man had also tried paintings thousands of years ago? How did he do that? What did he try to draw? All this was discovered by Visudada. We are going to listen the story of Visudada today. The name of the story is Picture That Told the History. It is written by Digvijay Patil, read by Rahul Kokit, and video editing is done by Ashwin Kumar Koekar. This is the creation of Manthan Learning Resources.
Isn't the world of art and drawing interesting? In fact, everything in nature has its own color. Different shapes are created by nature with so many colors, shades, and lines. People who enjoy and explore this world are called painters. Many times we color pictures, paint something, but who exactly started all this and when? Do you feel that our ancestor would have drawn and painted? And if they were drawing, where would be those paintings now? Which would be their favorite colors? Were the colors available or they made it on their own? Did they also have paper and brush? I have so many such questions in my mind. Do you also have such questions? Visudada also used to have many such questions. Today we are going to listen his story. Visudada used to love drawing. At the same time, he was interested in history too. So obviously, he studied history of paintings also. He studied paintings, history and archaeology. That is the study of ancient relics. Visudada had studied a lot about our ancestor and their houses, food, clothes, jewelry, and many more things. Be it the colorful 1500 years old Ajanta cave painting or 5000 year old pottery painting of Harappan culture. Dada was an expert of it, but he still wanted to find and study very old paintings, the paintings older than this. Visudada had received a lot of new information about our ancestor, the primitive man. The oldest relic of these ancestors are millions of years old. Their life was dependent on forest. Stone tools were useful for him to hunt and fill his stomach and protect himself. This primitive man used to have many difficult and arduous tasks like hunting during the day. But he must be doing many other things in free time. He may have told his friends the path of the fruit tree that he found that day. He may have told a thrilling story of how he hunted. He may have taught how to recognize the delicious bird that he ate that day by showing the sound of different birds. Sometimes the moon and stars in the sky may seem as a mystery to him. He also must have felt like sharing the things experienced by him. He must have wanted to tell what he saw and experienced. Maybe he would have drawn some lines on the ground to describe his experiences. Maybe someone would have painted on the stone wall with red clay so that it would be clearer and better. Sometimes he may have used limestone to make the picture long-lasting. That would be the beginning of the picture. Visudada concluded it at the end of his research and studies. Let the reason be anything, but this is true that the primitive man invented the art of drawing. There are some thousands of years old paintings from Africa, Europe, and America. Visudada studied these paintings too. He thought that in our country, stone tools and relics are found millions of years ago. In some places, paintings must be there. Some were found, but very less in number. Dada felt that it should be presented to the world. He read many books and met many great researchers, but he knew very little. Then he began to search for such pictures himself, but this task was not easy. The real question was from where to start, because stone tools are found all over India. Till then, Visudada had grown up, even by experience. He had started teaching his favorite subjects to other students. He also started research with his students in Madhya Pradesh. Visudada started searching at the places where primitive man used to live. They were having considerable success in that. These places were sometimes on the banks of the river and streams, sometimes in dense forests, and sometimes in caves near mountains. Sometimes there were paintings in such a caves, but very few. Most of the time nothing came out of it and there was a complete despair. But Visudada was not ready to give up. Sometimes the object you are looking for everywhere is suddenly found nearby. Something similar happened with Visudada. One day Dada had left Bhopal for Nagpur for some work. The train was moving slowly. As it was getting hot inside in the summer, his attention was outside of the window. Outside there were far-flung farms, few houses near the farm, and nearby farmers were seen working. When he looked closely, he could see mountains covered with the forest in the distance. Glimpses of pictures reappeared before his eyes. Seeing him paying so much attention, one old lady sitting in front said that it was Bhim Baithaka. The Pandavas lived there in exile. Dada's curiosity increased a lot, but now it was difficult to go immediately. He paused for a moment and thought. And Visudada left the scheduled journey and immediately landed at the next station. Visudada landed there, but he did not have any Google Maps like now. Nor did he have printed maps. Dada filled the water at the station and then asked the people for the address. The temperature was increasing and there was a dust in the air. But he was stepping forward. As the mountains reapproached, the field diminished and the bushes grew. But the wait was not over. In fact, there was a small temple of goddess at the foot of the mountain. There were some Buddhist stupas and other ancient relics. He also noticed it. At last, he came to the foothill of the temple. Tired of walking, he just sat there for a while. While he was thinking about where to go from here, he saw Sadhu Baba. He also lived nearby and knew about the caves. Visudada told him about the discovery of pictures of primitive man. Sadhu Baba agreed to help. Millions of years, hot sun, wind, rain had eroded this huge mountain in many places. It looked like a maze. In many places, large boulders were broken and trees were came out from them. There was no sign or evidence of human habitation. Of course, it would be easy to erase such traces in millions of years. Still, can man be protected from the rain here? Dada was thinking about this possibility. Some of the rocks were stacked on the top of each other, while some of the rocks in the middle were eroded by the wind, creating a natural ridge. But it seemed a little high. It was difficult to climb there. Then Dada suddenly realized that today it seemed to be high because in a few years, the soil level has shifted down due to soil erosion. Dada began to look up a little and in many places he stared, noticing the color of fire soot. In some places, it was a layer of dried moss. Then he saw a picture of some animal in red color. As they started to move a little bit, they started to see many different animals, dancing people. Going even further, hundreds of paintings appeared that still survived. Visudada was enormously happy. He was thrilled. Our ancestors also study paintings. For a long time, he just stared at all those treasure. Sadhu Baba shook him and brought him out of that world of pictures. Dada took a long round in all the area where he could record what could be stored in his eyes. Having been there for many years, many layers of paintings had accumulated. Yet it showed many figures and their subjects painted by the primitive man. The colors were red, white, black, and green, and many shaded of brown. Primitive humans used to make colors from objects that were easily found around them. It contained reddish clay, soot of fire, and sometimes colored green stones or limestone. So the color of the soil and their various shades were visible here. The paintings on the wall and the roof of these caves are mostly of animals. More of a hunter in it. These includes cows, deers, antelopes, tigers, unicorns, and buffaloes. There are more than 30 species of animals. Now let's see what these two pictures shows. This picture shows some animals and some people. Men have weapon in their hands. And in second picture, people are sitting on the animals. Look at the difference between these two pictures. However, many things come to mind. In second picture, men sitting on the animal tells us that domestication of animal had begun. That is man hunting and eating animals. But along with that, it had started to move from one place to another with their help and also hunt with their help. The first picture is blur. The colors are little rough. It may have been drawn earlier. Visudhadath's study had estimated the duration of these pictures. Many of these animals are no longer seen around Bhimbaitaka. The primitive man had painted everywhere that he found beautiful in nature. He used to see deer and cows running in herds in surrounding grasslands. Sometimes tigers and leopards are seen hunting for them. All these animals have body shape, foot movement, etc. It shows accurate observation of things. It sometimes shows a web of various lines in the stomach of an animal and sometimes a pattern of dots from which its imagination is also understood. Apart from large animals, seal, squirrel, fish and crab, etc. little creatures, however, did not escape from the notice of these painters. There are also pictures of people. There are men and women who go for hunting with bows and arrows and spears in their hand. Sometimes they are seen dancing together on happy occasion. In some places, they have made their fingerprints. Later, man started farming. So he built a hut near the farm and lived in the village. But still, he never forgot these caves. That is why there were later paintings with horses, chariot, and deities. So here, thousands of years of human history is unfolded like a movie. On that day, Visudhadath was happy to find the origin of his favorite art, painting. That day, while walking through the places of these pictures, Visudhadath had forgotten everything, even his thirst and hunger. At last, inevitably, he had to go back. He thanked Sadhu Baba and made his way back. Of course, he decided to return here as soon as possible. Over the next few years, Dada studied many of these rock paintings in and around Bhimbaitaka and understood the lifestyle of the primitive people. The study sparked enthusiasm among many local and foreign historians. Archaeological excavations at Bhimbaitaka have revealed the existence of early humans. The painting in these caves are said to be 10 to 15,000 years old. It also proved that early humans lived in these caves for millions of years. Due to all these studies, Visudhadath, that is Vishnu Sridhar Vakankar, was honored with Padma Shri by Government of India, and today he is known as Father of Indian Rock Painting Studies. Due to this perseverance and study of Visudhadath, the art of Indian primitive man was newly introduced to Indians and the world.